Hi, I'm Peter Kalmstrom of kalmstrom.com Business Solutions. In this demonstration, I will show you a PowerPoint feature that is old school, but is still working and still very useful, at least for me. And it is the storyboarding feature, as you see here. You find it right inside PowerPoint under storyboarding. If you have installed an old add-on from 2017, and I'll show you the URL for that. It's down here. Actually found it here on Microsoft Learn, and here's the link, the Team Foundation Server Standalone Office Integration. That's what I've installed, and here's what it does. It allows you to, I'm just gonna clear this out first, make it empty, Control A and delete to remove everything, and then I'm gonna go into the storyboard shapes. And this is of course useful when you want to talk about or build or, you know, brainstorm some kind of application. Then you can have all the regular components here. And to select one of these, the shapes, you simply double click it, and then you have a web browser window here, and then you can adjust the size to the display that you want. And then you use some of the components. There's a lot of these here. So for example, a progress bar is always useful. Make sure you select the right thing when you're dragging it. There we go, there's the progress bar. There is a list component there. All the usual things that you know, when you're building a UI for an application, there's a lot of it in here. You can also have a search window. So if you want a video, for example, you can search for that. There's a video component there, or a video player, a webcam kind of thing there. So a lot of things related to video there, for example. And a tree list is always a useful component there. Double click to get it in there. And of course, this is still, you know, PowerPoint. So you can use all the other features of PowerPoint, including coloring, animations, all kinds of things, and even VBA if you want to go really old school. That's it. That's my demo for this time. Yeah, there will of course be a link in the article and in the comments of the in the description of the YouTube video to this Team Server Standalone Office integration. And this page here, the official document, doesn't seem to exist anymore. But the feature still works in the latest version of PowerPoint. So I hope you'll find it as useful as I do. Thank you for watching this demonstration.